It was difficult for me to get along with my colleagues when I started working for this company. If you do something bad to me, trust me, I'll get back at you. Alright, so in the English language, there's something that is called phrasal verb. Phrasal verb is called phrasal because it consists of not only one word, but maybe two, maybe three. And it simply is a verb plus either an adverb or a preposition. So let's suppose that the verb pull, we all know the verb pull means to grab something towards your side. If you're walking into a restaurant or a shop, the door sign either says pull or push. So we all know that pull means grab something towards your side. But if you add a preposition after the word pull, for example, over, if you say pull over, does it still have the same meaning of pull? No. Now, pull over as a phrasal verb means to stop the car. Today and in this episode, I will talk about one of the most commonly used verbs, and this is get. Well, the word get or the verb get has too many meanings and can be used in too many different scenarios. I'm not gonna talk about that. I am going to talk about all the phrasal verbs of get. Stay tuned, everybody. I'll get back to you in a while. Welcome to a new episode from Fluency First. As I mentioned in the introduction, I am going to talk about all the phrasal verbs of the verb get. And the first one to start with is get across. The phrasal verb get across simply means to manage to move from one point to another or to the opposite side. For example, it's hard to get across the road when there is a lot of traffic. So get across the road here means to go to the other side of the road. And phrasal verb number two, and this is get along. Remember in the example I said at the beginning of the episode, it was difficult for me to get along with my colleagues when I moved to this new company. And get along here means to make a good relationship. So if you don't get along with someone, that means you both don't have this good relationship. So again, get along means to have a good relationship with someone. And phrasal verb number three, and this is get around. And there are two things to discuss about this phrasal verb. Now, the first meaning for get around is to physically be able to move or to go places. For example, the transportation system in Dubai makes it easy to get around the city. And here, get around means to go to different places in Dubai. Now, the second use of get around is to finally be able to finish something or to complete something. There are plenty of emails in the inbox, and I haven't gotten around to replying to any of them. And phrasal verb number three, and this is get away. And get away means to escape. For example, the dog got away from me at the park. The next phrasal verb is get away with something. So get away with means to escape the consequences of something bad or harmful that you've done. If you do something bad, there will be consequences, right? But if you get away with what you've done, that means you escape the consequences. For example, if you cheat on your girlfriend, you will never get away with it. She will get back at you. Now, this is the next phrasal verb. Get back at someone means to get revenge. So if someone did something bad to you, you will get back at him. And that means that you will get revenge. You will do something, maybe harmful, maybe annoying, maybe whatever, but something bad to him in return to what he has done to you. Now the next one is very easy and very popular. That is get back. And get back is an informal way of saying to return somewhere. For example, the traffic was so bad, it took me 2 hours to get back home. The next one is get by, and get by somehow related to having money. So if you don't have enough money, you won't be able to get by, you won't be able to survive. For example, it was hard for most of people to get by due to the unfortunate event of Corona. Many people have lost their jobs. The next one is get in. Get in means to physically go inside something. So for example, get in the car. That means you're asking someone or you're inviting someone to get inside of the car or to move inside of the car. Now the second meaning is kind of also informal and it means arrive. For example, our flight gets in at 7 a.m. and that means the flight arrives at 7 a.m. Now this one is very popular and commonly, widely is used. This one is get off. Get off simply means to leave a bus or a train or a car or a bicycle or any kind of surface. For example, I will get off the bus at the next station. If you spill coffee on your pants, it's very difficult to get the stain off. The next and the last is get over. Get over simply means to recover from something, either physically or emotionally. Let's give an example for get over something physically. I just got over a very bad flu, and that means I have recently physically recovered a bad flu. I was so sick and I recovered from this. Now the second example for get over something emotionally. It took him a long time to get over his dog's death. Now phrasal verbs are obviously one of the very important corners of the English language that you need to have a good grasp of. So it's very important to always try to gain more knowledge about the phrasal verbs. Now I want you to practice all the phrasal verbs that I've just talked about. Leave me some comments with examples on these phrasal verbs. I'd be so happy with that. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already. Thank you for watching and I wish you have a wonderful day wherever you are.